July has been an interesting month, packed with a lot of device announcements. Now the month is over, but there is a lot to look forward to. The August is packed with a whole lot of exciting product launches. Here's what is coming in the first week of the August. Tecno is bringing its POVA 2 to India on August 2nd. After its launch in the Philippines last month, the phone's selling point is its 7000 mAh battery capacity. The design is cool too, but the rest of the specifications are what you will find on the average and mid-range phones. Infinix, a sister company to Tecno, will also be announcing a new phone to the Indian market on August 2nd. The Infinix Smart 5A is a budget smartphone that will be having a 5000 mAh battery, dual cameras and an HD Plus display. On August 3rd, India will be getting its new Redmi Book laptops. Among the expected models is the Redmi Book 15, and it will be powered by the Intel 11th Gen processor. It has been reported that it will be having a 65-watt charger. From the Realme, we are going to see Realme Mag, that is a magnetic wireless technology that Realme will be announcing on August 3rd. We already showed you what the chargers will look like, but that is not only the interesting thing. The manufacturer will also announce a smartphone called as a Realme Flash, and it will be the first Android phone to support magnetic wireless charging. And it has been 6 months since the IQ7 was announced. Now a successor is on the way. Actually, it is going to announce with 2 successors, the IQ8 and the IQ8 Pro will be announced on August 4th. And they are expected to come with a brand new flagship display and the Snapdragon 888 Plus processor. PM Narendra Modi ji has announced to launch e-Rupee digital payments platform today. The launch of the digital payment solution will happen at 4:30 PM via video conferencing due to COVID-19 situation in the country. Motorola will be holding an unveiling event in China on August 5th. Last week, the company announced the H20, H20 Pro and H20 Lite smartphones in the global markets. The Vanilla and Pro models are expected to go official later this week in China. Recent teasers by Motorola's China division suggest that H20 Pro may debut in the Chinese market with the Motorola HS Pro moniker. And the Motorola official said that the flagship model of this series of mobile phones will have a 100-megapixel main camera and a 50x periscope telephoto lens. We can see it in these sample images that the camera of this mobile phone supports continuous zoom, which can be seamlessly zoomed from 0.5 times to 50 times. There is a trending post in the Twitter posted by Ankur Sharma that his wife went out for cycling with a new OnePlus Note 2 which is 5 days old. All of a sudden the phone busted and the smoke started coming out of it. Due to this blast, she met with an accident and she is in trauma after this incident. But now this post has been deleted by the owner and the leakster Abhishek Yadav mentioned that OnePlus is very clear enough to negotiate with these kind of issues. The Redmi K40 Gaming Edition got a new colorway this week. The name of the new color translates to inverse scale and it stands out pretty much from the others in its own way. Real life photos as well as an unboxing video of the new variant have surfaced and they gave us a better look at the device. Flipkart has announced that it will be holding another round of its Big Saving Days sale. The company is yet to announce the sale dates and currently only has a banner, which states that the sale is coming soon and during the sale, the company will be offering deals and discount across its website and will also offer Axis and ICICI Bank cardholders an instant discount of 10% during the sale. The new Xbox Series S and Series X gaming consoles are the best-selling Xbox consoles even after the huge high supply issues. And Xbox is also trying to bring its Xbox Game Pass service to more screens, one of which is TV. Xbox said last month that it is working with TV manufacturers to bring the Xbox experience to internet-connected TVs with no extra hardware expected a controller. This app will allow users to access its game streaming service called xCloud on their TVs. Huawei will be soon launching a 100-watt Huawei charger with a model code HW200500 and C00 has been certified by the China's 3C. We don't know when Huawei will be launching a smartphone with 100-watt charger, but since its 100-watt adapter has been bagged 3C certification. As per the highlights of July, Xiaomi is now the second biggest smartphone manufacturer in the world in the terms of market share. Sitting at the top of the list is Samsung with a shipment volume of 59 million units, 4 million units more than it shipped in the same quarter in 2020. While it has shipped more units, its market share has been dropped from 19.5% to 18.8%. Coming in the second place is Xiaomi with 53.1 million units shipped and a 16.9% of market share. There is a new huge increase from Xiaomi from the 28.5 million units shipped over year on year from its market share of 10.3%. And IDC has stated that the company has recorded a growth of 86.6%. And the third in the list, we have Apple with a 44.2 million units with a 14.1% of market share. After Apple, Oppo and its sister company Vivo take the fourth and fifth spots with a 32.8 and 31.6 million units shipped. Oppo has a market share of 10.5% last year and recorded a growth of 33.7% right now. Vivo market share was 10.1% last year and it recorded a growth of 33.7%. Xiaomi is currently working on its MIUI 13 skin, which is expected to launch later this month. MIUI 13 is expected to bring in new features like increased virtual memory expansion and a redesigned control center. As per the new report, Xiaomi has delayed the release of MIUI 13 as it requires further optimization before its release. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.